Somewhat ironically, here at the Cashman Center, as things are wrapping up, it's actually getting busier. More and more reporters are coming in, they're filing their stories live from the press risers. One of the questions we're going to be asking as we go out and talk to people about how they're feeling about the results is, was Nevada ready for this caucus, for this precedent-setting caucus to be happening here, to be up in the first of the nation primaries and caucuses category? And it's been very interesting here. I'm seeing a lot of exhausted volunteers, a lot of exhausted press. I'm not seeing nearly the same kind of coverage, obviously, that we saw in Iowa. At the same time, we are seeing a lot of interest and a lot of passion and a lot of people coming in from out of state to sort of drive this thing forward. So it's going to be very interesting to see what Nevada has to say, see what the state parties have to say about how this has worked out for them. Just as I was about to leave, I had a chance I'd been waiting for pretty much since I'd arrived in Vegas. I spoke to Jill Derby. She's the chair of the Democratic Party here in Nevada.
I just have to start out by saying how excited we are about the turnout in Nevada, because it's really just over the top. We never expected such a huge turnout, and we're feeling very gratified by it. But let me just explain to you that the idea is the DNC looked at who's in the early state calendar. And you know that whoever, Iowa, New Hampshire, gives enormous momentum to candidates that can really determine the outcome of who's successful in the nominating process. They decided we need regional representation, so they had South Carolina last cycle to bring in a Southern voice, and particularly an African American constituency. Then they looked west, because the West is really the new frontier of the Democratic Party, the Intermountain West, particularly all of it trending Democratic. And they looked, and there was quite a competitive process. Nevada got the nod, partly for reasons that Nevada really looks like America.
Look for the rest of that interview on the Uptake Mogulus channel. In the meantime, I was wrapping up. The results are almost all in. We are now at 76% of the precincts reporting, and the CBS network has called it for Clinton. I believe some of the other networks have called it for Clinton as well. After taking care of some logistics, I got the alarming email that things might not be as simple as they seemed. So I booked it to our next temporary studio space here at the Travelodge to see what I could find out. So Obama won more delegates. At least probably, we don't know for sure yet. But Hillary won the popular vote? No wait, it's not the popular vote. She won more of the initial delegates? I tell you what, tune in, and Noah Kunin is going to come along and explain it all in a much more succinct and sane way than I possibly can. In the meantime, these people partying to celebrate Hillary's victory were correct. She did win here in Nevada. We'd all probably best remember that we're talking about 4 states out of 50. And that the only official delegates actually apportioned so far are those from New Hampshire. And that ties Hillary and Obama neck and neck at 9 delegates each. And according to CNN, with their projections of which delegates will be assigned, we're looking at 36 Clinton, 38 Obama. So this is still really anybody's race. Again, 4 states out of 50. This is Corinne McDermott for the Uptake at the Travelodge outside of McClellan Airport.